Hey, it's Professor Dave. Let's do some more algebra.
He knows a lot about all kinds of stuff, Professor Dave explains.
We just learned about all kinds of roots. Square roots, cube roots, and more. We learned that they can also be represented with fractional exponents, where x to the 1/2 and the square root of x mean exactly the same thing. So we are now ready to use our understanding of roots and exponents to solve algebraic equations that are a little trickier than the ones we looked at previously. Let's start with a simple one, the square root of x plus 9 equals 5. Notice here that the square root symbol extends over this entire term, so it's not just 9 more than the square root of x. It's the quantity x plus 9, and then the square root of that whole thing. This means we have to be very specific regarding the order in which we do things to try to get x by itself. We can't subtract 9 from both sides and expect to get the square root of x, because the 9 is inside the square root. So we would just get the square root of x plus 9 minus 9, and that just makes things worse. Instead, we have to get rid of the square root first. Well, we know that the opposite of taking the square root of something would be squaring it. So we can square both sides to get rid of this square root. That gives us x plus 9 equals 25. To really prove that squaring a square root gets rid of the root, let's remember that taking the square root is the same as raising to the 1/2 power, so we can rewrite this equation like this. On the left, we have this term, to the 1/2 power to the second power. We can recall from our rules of manipulating exponents that x to the a to the b equals x to the a times b, and here a times b, or 1/2 times 2, equals 1. So the 1/2 and the 2 essentially negate one another to just leave the term by itself. Now things look much simpler. X plus 9 equals 25, so we subtract 9 from both sides, and we get x equals 16. How about something a little trickier? The quantity x plus 2 to the 3/2 power equals 8. We still just go from the outside in, undoing every operation that acts on the variable we are solving for, one at a time. First, we have to get rid of the exponent. How do we get rid of the 3/2? The fastest way to do it would be to raise both sides to the 2/3 power. If we raise this term, that is to the 3/2, to the 2/3 power, we are raising it to the 3/2 times 2/3 power. And if we do this, everything cancels, and we just get 1 as the exponent. Another way to do it would be to square both sides and then take the cube root. But why do two steps when you can do one? Now on the right, we have 8 to the 2/3. This we can just evaluate by taking the cube root, which is 2, and then squaring to get 4. Now we are left with x plus 2 equals 4, so we just subtract 2 from both sides to get x equals 2. When we have something like x squared plus 5 equals 41, this is also quite easy. We just subtract 5 and then take the square root. But remember, when we take the square root of something, we get two answers, in this case, positive 6 and negative 6. So we have to keep in mind that these types of equations have two solutions. Let's do one more. 3 root x minus 1 equals root x plus 1. Certainly, we must get rid of these square roots, so let's square both sides. Don't forget that on the left, we square the 3 and the radical term, so we get 9 times the quantity x minus 1. And on the right, we just lose the radical and get x plus 1. Then we distribute the 9 to get 9x minus 9. Subtract x, add 9, divide by 8 to get 10 over 8, simplify by dividing the top and bottom by 2, and x will equal 5/4. So as you can see, once you know all the rules for how to manipulate roots and exponents, it's just a matter of applying them strategically to undo all the operations that are acting on the variable you want to solve for. To get just a little more practice, let's check comprehension. We'll be right back. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.